present effective enzymatic hydrolysis period on saccharification of oil palm trunk, SAT. In brief, it's OBT. Here are the contents of my presentation chronologically. And you know, I have to say, this project I have done in Malaysia, actually on the basis of Malaysia's problem, and under International Islamic University Malaysia, in collaboration with University of Brunei Darussalam and Forest Research Institute Malaysia. So I think most of you heard about palm oil, right? It's kind of a popular vegetable oil nowadays, and especially in Asian countries, it's economical as well. But do you know how this palm oil we get it? We get it actually from the palm fruit. And for that, we have to plant palm fruit in the palm garden. Normally it takes 2 to 3 years to get the fruit, from the plant, and after that, until 20 to 25 years, it keeps giving fruit. Then what happens? The palm plants, they just get unproductive to the eye of industries, right? And then what are we gonna do? Some industries, they just burn them out because they want to get rid of it and they want to replant it again. But for us, who really think of environment, we think that's a crazy idea to burn the whole garden. So we came up with some new research, and we can really utilize this huge biomass because they carry a lot of lignocellulose, and lignocellulose actually contains cellulose, hemicellulose, starch, and all others. They are actually sole component of sugar. That's how we want to produce sugar from oil palm trunk. Research hypothesis: how we produce sugar? Actually, the lignocellulose is full of polysaccharide. So we used yeast and water with the polysaccharide, and it broke down to sucrose. Sucrose is the simple disaccharide. And when sucrose comes into contact with the water and yeast, yeast contains enzyme. Actually, enzyme is the hydrolysis key reagent here. So enzyme runs the reaction and produces simple sugars, glucose and fructose. Why we are using yeast? Not other kind of enzyme, you know, enzyme is kind of expensive. So that's why we are using yeast. It's superficially accessible in local and international market. It's cheaper than other hydrolysis key vehicles. It has genuine hydrolysis capability biologically and creates no chemical waste. That means it's completely environment friendly. Why our research is significant? Because we want to convert the OPT waste into value-added products. We want to minimize the environmental pollution, because if we burn it, it creates really a lot of flue gas and what causes greenhouse effect. So we wanted to really reduce it, and we want to reduce the global warming as well. And we want to produce sustainable energy with the simplest approach, because using yeast is saccharomyces cerevisiae scientific name. You are even using yeast to make your cake. So you know, everybody will know about this approach. Our research aim was to investigate OPT saccharification